Thank you. Good afternoon. I would like to welcome parents, family, friends, staff, honored guests, and anyone else who has Wi-Fi and a very good data plan. My name is Mike Edgar, and I am the Vice Principal of Clarence Fulton Secondary School. It is my pleasure to be your Master of Ceremonies for today's virtual graduation celebration. I was lucky enough to spend three quarters of the last year with this fine group of graduates. I would have loved to spend more time with them, but we all had to leave and learn new terms, such as quarantine, social distancing, respiratory etiquette, and speaking moistly. We have had to adapt to many things in the past 3 months, and I am proud of how this group has reacted and pulled together. Today, we are honored to recognize Clarence Fulton's graduating students, the grad class of 2020. I would like to call Fulton student Kai Shibata to lead us in the singing of O Canada. Thank you, Kai. We will now hear greetings from the Okanagan Indian Band. We acknowledge and recognize the Okanagan people on whose traditional territory our school district resides. I would like to call upon Chief Byron Lewis of the Okanagan Indian Band to welcome us to the Okanagan Nation and to offer his greetings to the class of 2020.
What? Good morning to all high school graduates. My name is Byron Lewis. I'm the chief of the Okanagan Indian Band. On behalf of the Seal people and also of Chief and Council, I'm here to congratulate you on your accomplishment. Your friends and family should be proud of what you have achieved despite the recent pandemic crisis we continue to face together. I would like everyone to always remember that life is full of learning. We always learn. We're never going to stop learning. And what you've learned today is something that you can carry on into tomorrow. But always remember that we always have to make choices. And whatever your choices be, I hope that they're positive and it helps you with your goals in life. And whatever you strive to do, try to do your best. Try not to be as good as everybody or better than everybody, but try your best to be the best person you can be. And as you go forward, always be kind to yourself and be kind to others, because the world is a hard enough place without being too hard on yourself. And try to be good terms with everyone, and all the best to you. Okay, thank you very much, and I wish you all the best.
At this time, please join me in welcoming Miss Lynn Seed, principal of Clarence Fulton Secondary School, as she addresses this year's graduates.
This is a message for Clarence Fulton's graduating class of 2020, a group that will forever be remembered as the students that had the most challenging grade 12 year of any on record. However, this is also a group that will be praised for their actions and leadership during this difficult time. It is the class of 2020 that willingly sacrificed some of their best high school days so as to protect their health and the health of others. And it is this class that will soon be leaving the comforts of Fulton and heading into a new world that will be very different than the one we lived in before COVID-19. I have every confidence that the skills and talents that you developed at Clarence Fulton will be put to great use as you become leaders in society and the agents of change necessary to transform the world. Grads of 2020, I know that this is not the way that you wanted to end your high school careers. However, I implore you to not allow any setbacks to slow you down and to always remember that tough times don't last, tough people do. I leave you with the following quote. To you and to all, I repeat, never yield of discouragement. Do not lose trust. Do not allow your hope to be extinguished. Always remember, be kind, be calm, and be safe.
Hey grads, when you came to Fulton in grade 8, you were the uninitiated.
The beaners. You were worried about locker combinations, finding classrooms, learning social norms, and surviving the wrath of senior students.
Nervous about meeting new people and making new friends.
But those nerves didn't last long.
Before we knew it, you were on your way.
You figured out Fulton's crazy schedule.
You made new friends, and you found that senior students were not that sinister after all.
And you found your ideal lunchtime hangout spot.
Over the years, you became Fulton Maroons.
You were actors.
You were athletes.
And mathletes.
You joined leadership.
You gave it your all during Spirit Week.
We've watched you grow.
We have cheered on your victories.
And we've walked you through all your failures.
We have pushed you to be better, whether on the field, the court, or in the classroom.
We have always wanted the best for you.
Now you're the big kids.
The grad class of 2020.
You figured out how to navigate Fulton in grade 8.
And now you're heading out to navigate through life.
Grad is looking different this year.
But we want to say...
we are proud of you.
You have it in you to reach your goals.
So step forward with courage into the next stage of your life.
Congratulations, grads of 2020.
It is now time to introduce the members of the graduating class. The students will be introduced in alphabetical order. Mountain West Studios will be taking a professional photo of each student and providing this picture as part of each student's grad package. This allows you to remain on your couch or in your backyard or floating in your pool or wherever your family has decided to enjoy this ceremony. Before each student is introduced, they will light a candle, which represents the light of learning each of our graduates has required as they progress through Clarence Fulton Secondary School. All graduates have had opportunities to experience success, strive for excellence, and become responsible citizens. Fiza Akhtar. Fiza will cherish the memories that she has made at Fulton. She would like to thank her teachers, friends, and family for the constant support. Though she enjoyed her high school experience, she is excited to see what comes next. Fiza is the recipient of the Teens Count 2 scholarship. Congratulations, Fiza. Hayden Alaric. Hayden's future plans are to go to BCIT to become a computer engineer and or a database administrator. Hayden would like to thank all teachers who have supported him, as well as his friends and family. Good luck, Hayden. Sulman Ali. Sulman would like to thank his friends, family, teachers, and especially parents for all the help and mentoring they provided throughout his life. He will be pursuing engineering at UBCO and hopes to own his own business in the future. Sulman is the lucky recipient of the following bursaries: the Fraternal Order of the Eagle Scholarship, the Mission Hill Elementary PAC Citizen Scholarship, the District Project Scholarship from the Ministry of Education. Well done, Sulman. Simran Bajwa. Simran would like to thank her family and friends for always being supportive. Simran plans to attend UBC for a political science degree and then attend law school to become a real estate lawyer. Simran will be receiving the following awards: the North Okanagan Realtor Award and the Jeff Thorlickson Memorial Scholarship. Congratulations, Simran. Dylan Beaumont. Dylan would like to thank her mom and dad for helping her get through school. She will cherish the friendship she's made at Clarence Fulton. She thanks her teachers, friends, and especially her family for their love and support. Dylan is excited to take a gap year and start traveling around the world. We wish you the best, Dylan. Braden Beckley. Braden would like to thank his mom and dad, and especially his Nana. Braden's looking forward to becoming an aircraft maintenance technician. Also, a big thanks to the 4 years of football with Coach Scheller. Good luck, Braden. Morgan Becker. Morgan would like to thank her dad for always helping her with the more challenging homework. Morgan will be attending Okanagan College in the fall and see where she goes from there. We wish you well, Morgan. Amber Bell Postel. Amber would like to thank her friends and family for supporting her through this journey. If given the chance to do it all again, she would politely decline. Good luck, Amber. Jaslyn Bernakovich. Jaslyn would like to thank her family and friends for their love and support. There are people in her life who have helped her get through these past 5 years. Jaslyn is thrilled to go to Vancouver in the spring to attend a design school. Jaslyn is the recipient of the following awards: the Clarence Fulton Staff Award and the Ann Varden Memorial Bursary. Congratulations, Jaslyn. Araya Bernard. Araya would like to thank her family and friends for all their support. Araya would also like to thank her teachers for helping her get through high school. In the fall, she is planning on upgrading her sciences before pursuing a degree in chemical engineering. Best of luck, Araya. Madison Borovchuk. Madison would like to thank her friends and family and the Fulton staff for all of the support over the years. Madison plans to take a year off and then return to her studies. She wants to pursue a career in the medical field. Madison is the recipient of the Okanagan Landing Volunteer Firefighters Legacy Award. Good job, Madison. Tyler Blundell. Tyler would like to thank his mom and dad for all the support they've given him throughout his life. He'd also like to thank his family and friends for the great memories shared. He is very enthusiastic to pursue industrial mechanics at Thompson River University and receive his red seal in welding. Good luck, Tyler. CG Bott. CG would like to thank his parents who gave him endless support and patience throughout the last 5 years. He would also like to thank his friends and football teammates who made his time in high school a memorable one. Wishing you well, CG. Andrew Cantaloupe. Andrew would like to thank all of his family, even his brother. Andrew's future plans are to go back to school for business. Best of luck, Andrew. Hayden Catt. Some might say I'm a legend, but I don't see it this way. Over the past 5 years, as I walk these halls of wisdom, I've reflected on my time here. I must say I was busy doing everything from teams to team managing to Spirit Week, rugby and football, and spending time with the guys and even Scheller. To the grad class of 2020, today I say goodbye. To some, see you in a year. To others, see you tomorrow. For a few, I will be taking with me my acquired skills to my next adventure. My future career goal is to get my business degree in commercial management and commercial realty. Hayden is the recipient of the Fraternal Order of the Eagles Ladies Auxiliary Award. Congratulations, Hayden. Josh Collins. Josh would like to thank his family, his dad, and mom's side of the family, as well as his stepdad, Lyle, and Austin. Thank you for the push to finish school. Without it, he would never have made it to this day. Good luck in the future, Josh. Emily Covell. Emily would like to thank everyone from Fulton that has been there for her throughout it all. She wouldn't be where she is today without all of you. She is so glad that this part of her life is over. Best of luck with the next phase, Emily. Allison Critchley. Allison would like to thank her friends, family, and teachers for supporting both her love for sewing and for supporting her in general. She hopes to pursue this love in a future career. Allison is the recipient of a district project scholarship from the Ministry of Education. Way to go, Allison. Andrew Cusveller. Andrew would like to thank his mom and dad for helping him get through school. He is very glad that he is done. Andrew has been awarded the Smart and Caring Community Fund Scholarship. Good job, Andrew. Aaron Edwards. When Aaron was missing, you could find him in Mr. Deschamps' class, or Art, or at Timmy's. Thanks to Mr. D, his mom, his brother, Ms. Titro, for supporting him all these years and helping him get here today. Best of luck, Aaron. Drew Effrey. Drew is thankful for all the friends he's made and everyone who helped him graduate. His plans are to graduate from Vancouver Film School and to hopefully be on the big screen one day. Good luck, Drew. Jenna Faulkner. Jenna would like to thank Mr. Levi and her theater family. They were the people that made her look forward to school. Jenna is the recipient of the District Excellence Scholarship for Community Service. Well done, Jenna. Kevin Forson. At school, Kevin will be remembered for his extra large coffee and his tendency to procrastinate. He would like to thank his family for the love and encouragement during all his years at Clarence Fulton. He plans to pursue the culinary arts. Kevin will be receiving the Vernon Farmers Market Bursary. Good luck in the future, Kevin. Jacob Friesen. Jacob would like to thank all his teachers for encouraging him to do his best. He would not have been able to make it through the past 5 years without their help. He has made lifelong friends. High school will be a memory that he will forever remember, and he's so glad to be out of school. Best wishes, Jacob. Samuel Fuster. Samuel just wants to thank his fellow grads for making this fun. Also, a special thanks to Suman Ali for being such a good-looking lad. I love you, Sully. Good luck in the future, Sam. Brett Geese. Brett would like to thank his mom for always nagging at him to do his assignments, and his friends for stealing all his jokes. Brett is very excited to start his electronic engineering degree in September. Brett has been awarded the Okanagan Landing Volunteer Firefighter Legacy Award. Well done, Brett. Connor Hansen. Connor is looking forward to pursuing the aircraft engineering program at Okanagan College this September. He would like to thank his parents, friends, and teachers for the support they have given him throughout high school. Congrats to all the grads. Good luck, Connor. Tori Hopman. Tori enjoyed playing basketball, volleyball, and soccer in all her years at Fulton. She plans to study kinesiology and play soccer at the University of Winnipeg, where she received a full athletic scholarship. Tori will be receiving two bursary awards, the Jamie Sweet Memorial Athletic Bursary and the District Project Scholarship from the Ministry of Education. Congratulations, Tori. Emma Hayden. Emma would like to thank her family for putting her in music, theater, and dance lessons, and helping her get through school. She'd also like to thank family and friends for all the love and support. Emma will cherish her friendships she has made. Thank you to her teachers, especially her cafeteria teacher, for supporting her and helping her throughout school. Her future plans are to follow her lifelong goals of music. Best of luck, Emma. Jake Hillared. Jake would like to thank his mom for letting him move to Surrey so he can go to school there. Blood, sweat, and respect. First two you give, the last one you earn. Wishing you well, Jake. Cole Hutchinson. Cole is looking forward to continuing his job with the City of Vernon and furthering his training. He would like to thank his family for helping him through high school and getting him to this point. Cole would also like to thank one of his favorite teachers, Mrs. Harrison, for always being supportive and willing to talk. Good luck in the future, Cole. Dayton Innenhag. Dayton would like to especially thank his mom and dad for helping him get through school. He would also like to thank his teachers and coaches for their support. Dayton is the recipient of the following bursaries and scholarships: the Silver Star Rotary Okanagan Entrance Scholarship and the Jamie Sweet Memorial Athletic Bursary. Well done, Dayton. Mika Isnardi. Mika is planning on going to school to obtain her Bachelor of Science and specialize in respiratory therapy. For many years, she has been recognized as a kind person in the school. She is something she would like to continue being recognized for throughout her life. She would like to thank Mrs. Van Vliet for never giving up on her, Mr. Santos for always having time and encouraging her writing, and Mrs. Arnold for being a comforting presence and someone she will always remember. Mika is the recipient of the Graham Lloyd Memorial Scholarship and the We Care Home Health Services Scholarship. Great job, Mika. Victor Jacobson. Victor has many happy memories at Fulton and is happy to be graduating. Victor's favorite teachers have got to be Mr. Bowl and Mrs. Harrison. He would like to make more memories here at Fulton, but graduation has arrived and he is ready to say goodbye. He says good luck to all the students at Fulton. You will be great people someday and all of you will leave your mark on this world. Good luck in the future, Victor. Colin Johnson. Colin would like to say thank you to his closest friends for the experience and all the good times. It was truly inspiring high school experience and he can't wait for the high school reunion. Colin is super excited to start life in the real world and move towards his future. Thank you to his family and friends for all their love and support. Best of luck, Colin. Keegan Jones. Keegan would like to thank Vicky, his tutor, for helping him throughout his high school career, Cindy Tatro for having a space that he could go for help, and his mom and his grandma. Good luck in the future, Keegan. Youngbin Kim. Youngbin would like to thank his mom. He wouldn't be where he is today without her and has much love and appreciation for her. Also, many thanks to his dad and his friends. Love you all. Best wishes, Youngbin. Jade Klimp. Jade will be attending Okanagan College to obtain an associate's degree of arts. She also plans to incorporate traveling within these years. A special thanks to her mom for supporting her and her dad for driving her to school every morning. Congratulations, Jade. Kiara Korberg. Kiara would like to thank her family and friends and all of those who made high school memorable. Kiara, we wish you the best of luck. Congratulations. Melissa Krenning. Melissa is thankful for the lifelong friendships and memories she's formed throughout her school years. She would like to thank her family for the love and support she always received and plans to head to a big city to expand her horizons. Melissa is the recipient of the following: the Silver Star Rotary Okanagan College Entrance Scholarship and the District Project Scholarship from the Ministry of Education. Congratulations, Melissa. Amy Cronert. Amy would like to thank all the teachers who have helped her along the way, as well as her family for always being there for her. She will always remember that family that Fulton is. She plans to become successful in business. Thank you to her father for teaching her everything he knows. On to better things. Good luck, Amy. Georgia Lannan. Georgia would like to thank her parents for encouraging her to follow her dreams. She'd also like to thank Mrs. Harrison for always being there for her and keeping her motivated. She looks forward to becoming a physiotherapist. Georgia will be receiving the Vantage One Credit Union bursary. Good luck, Georgia. Matthew Latham. Matthew would like to thank all the staff and teachers for helping him get through all his years of high school and always giving him extra help when he needed it. He would also like to thank his mom and stepdad for always supporting him when times were tough. Best wishes, Matthew. Hyunjin Lee. Hyunjin would like to thank her parents for letting her move to Canada so she could meet everyone and have such a good time. Also, she would like to thank everyone for being good friends with her. She loves you all and hopes to see you again. Good luck in the future. Congratulations, Hyunjin. Emily Lahoux. Emily would like to thank her parents, teachers, and friends for getting her through the year. She is looking forward to taking a year off, then going to school to become a dental hygienist. Best of luck, Emily. Marcus Leafke. Marcus would like to thank all the teachers that have helped him throughout his years at Fulton. He would also like to thank his coaches for volunteering their time in order to help him grow as an athlete. Good luck in the future, Marcus. Chaeyun Lim. Chaeyun would like to thank her family and friends that she's met at Fulton. We wish you the best of luck, Chaeyun. Helen Lowe. Helen's future goals consist of becoming an electrician, traveling to Europe, and climbing cliffs, literally and figuratively. Helen would like to thank her teachers, friends, and family for the knowledge and support they have given her. Helen is the recipient of the following: the Vernon Fish and Game Scholarship and the Mr. G. Alfred Harrop Scholarship as well. Congratulations, Helen. Destiny Lulu Matus. Destiny would firstly like to thank Kathleen and Lynn for helping her and pushing her to do better, and for being epic and amazing. She would also like to thank all the teachers who helped her out throughout the school years. Destiny is receiving the following bursaries and scholarships: the Sydney Frederick Ward Memorial Award, the Mission Hill Elementary PAC Citizen Scholarship, and a district project scholarship from the Ministry of Education. Way to go, Destiny. Tara McKenzie. Tara would like to thank her family and friends who supported her through her time at Fulton. Tara, we wish you the best of luck. Karn Malhotra. Karn would like to thank his family for the consistent support. His favorite memory from high school was going to the provincial basketball tournament this year. Lastly, Karn would like to shout out to all the boys for all of the memories. Karn is the recipient of the Jordan Young Memorial Scholarship. Congratulations, Karn. Sarah Mann. Sarah would like to thank her parents, Kathleen and Mr. Thompson, for getting her through this final year. Her high school career was sick, and real life is going to be even sicker. She liked to say that you're all sweet and she wishes you all the best. Sarah will be receiving the A&W scholarship. Well done, Sarah. Nemel McDonald. High school did not end the way Nemel thought it would, but he still is grateful for the loved ones and friends for helping him get through the school year. Nemo plans to go into electrical engineering in the future. Nemo is the recipient of the following awards: the Vernon Teachers Association Award and the District Excellence Scholarship. Congratulations, Nemo. Owen McKill. Owen would like to thank his family and his close friends for helping him achieve success in racing motorcycles. He would also like to thank everyone for all the laughs and good times throughout his high school experience. During the past few years, Owen was a member of the 2019 Canadian ISDE team that competed in Portugal. He was a silver medalist in the expert category. Way to represent. Congratulations, Owen. Fiona Milne. Fiona is looking forward to attending administrative assistant course at Okanagan College in September. She's also planning on traveling after finishing school next year. Fiona is the recipient of the Armstrong Regional Cooperative Bursary. Congratulations, Fiona. Shakira Milne. Shakira's future plans include receiving a diploma in early childhood education and working towards becoming a teacher. She would like to thank her family, friends, and teachers who continually helped her to succeed. Shakira is the recipient of the William D. and Eleanor Jerry Hamilton Scholarship. Well done, Shakira. Sam Moore. Sam would like to thank his family and would like to congratulate the grad class of 2020. Sam is receiving the following scholarships: the QP Local 5523 Vernon School District Employees Union Scholarship and the Fulton Humanities Scholarship. Congratulations, Sam. Julia Moore. Julie would like to thank Mrs. Tatro, Mr. Ladner, Scheller, both Olsons, Mrs. Harrison, Maddie Hoy, and all her friends who she will miss so much. In the future, Julia plans to work, travel, and enjoy living. Best of luck, Julia. Kylie Murphy. Kylie would like to thank her parents, friends, and teachers for always being supportive. Kylie is glad to have attended Fulton and is glad for her long-lasting friendships. Kylie plans to eventually attend the Emily Carr University. Kylie is the recipient of the following awards: the J&R Memorial Scholarship and the District Project Scholarship from the Ministry of Education. Well done, Kylie. Kiara Naherny. Kiara is thankful for her family and friends who have been so supportive during her high school career. Kiara plans to travel in the future and is very excited for what life has to offer. Best wishes, Kiara. Sawako Nakazoto. Sawako would like to thank everyone at Fulton for supporting her and for being so kind and welcoming. Also, she would like to thank everyone for being good friends with her. Congratulations to Sawako. Good luck in the future. Ethan Newman. Ethan attended Harwood Elementary until grade 6, then Ellison Elementary for grade 7, and then continued on to Fulton for grades 8 through 12. His favorite classes were science, math, PE, and foods. Ethan wants to give a huge thank you to Mr. Ladner. He wouldn't be where he is today without Mr. Ladner constantly pushing him to attend classes and helping him with his schoolwork. His future endeavors are to become a geologist or a firefighter. Best of luck, Ethan. Lachlan O'Keefe. Lachlan would like to thank his friends and family for supporting him along the way. A special thanks to his mom for trying to wake him up every day. Good luck in the future, Lachlan. Seth Pallister. Seth would like to thank his teachers, coaches, teammates, and friends for the great memories he made throughout his years at Fulton. He would also like to thank his family for their support and guidance. Best wishes, Seth. Ashton Peedy. Ashton would like to thank his family and especially his sister Bridget for always having his back and Mrs. Tatro for always helping him. Ashton will always remember the fun times during Spirit Week, Go Yellow. In the future, Ashton plans to work in sports management. Good luck, Ashton. Angela Pipito. From the bottom of her heart, Ange would like to thank her family for raising a legend and the Fulton staff for being so cool. Also her friends for helping her shop in the children's section. As Robin Williams once said, you're only given one little spark of madness. You mustn't lose it. Be true to yourself, cherish your insanity, nurture it. And once it has reached its full potential, use it to take over the world. Angela is well deserving for the following awards. The Vernon Rotary Club Scholarship, the Mission Hill Elementary PAC Citizen Scholarship, the UBC Okanagan Presidential Scholars Award, the Tom Est Experiential Award, and the District Project Scholarship from the Ministry of Education. Well done, Angela. Slade Phillips. Slade would like to thank his family and friends for their support throughout this journey. He would also like to thank Ms. Harrison and Mrs. Olson for being such amazing grad sponsors. Slade is really going to miss all the amazing staff and hopes to see them again sometime. In the future, Slade plans on becoming a member of the RCMP so that he can help people. Best of luck, Slade. Good job. Kylene Richardson. Kylene would like to thank her parents, friends, and teachers for encouraging her to always be her best self. Her future plans are to attend UBCO in the fall to obtain a degree in psychology. Kylene is the recipient of the following bursaries and scholarships: the Clarence Fulton Student Leadership Award, the Jordan Young Memorial Scholarship, the Vernon Principals and Vice Principals Association Scholarship, the District Project Scholarship from the Ministry of Education. Congratulations, Kylie. Aurora Riddams. Aurora has thoroughly enjoyed her high school experience at Fulton, but she is beyond thrilled to be moving on to the next stage of her life. She is looking forward to traveling the world, meeting new people, and gaining new perspectives. Good luck, Aurora. Cassidy Ryan. Cassidy will cherish the friendships and memories she has made at Fulton. She would like to thank her teachers, friends, and especially her family for all the love and support. Cassidy is excited to pursue her career in rodeo. Best of luck, Cassidy. Kana Saki. Kana would like to thank everyone at Fulton for supporting her and for being so kind and welcoming. They have helped her overcome many challenges and she will never forget her time here and wishes everyone all the best. Good luck in the future, Kana. Jackson Sampert. Jack would like to thank everyone who has helped him through high school. He would like to thank Mr. Scheller, Mrs. Thorburn, and Mr. G in particular for being some of the best teachers a kid could ask for. Congrats to the class of 2020. Best wishes, Jackson. Tatiana Sands. Tatiana is proud to be graduating from Fulton and excited to move forward in life. She wants to make new memories and have new adventures. She met a lot of great people at Fulton. She made a lot of close friends, even a best friend, and many caring staff. She's sad to go, but with everything ending, she can look forward to a new beginning. Good luck, Tatiana. Jana Schellenberg. Jana would like to thank all her friends and teachers who have supported her all these years. She would also give a special shout out to Morgan Becker, the best friend you could ever ask for. Best of luck, Jana. Ethan Sheeman. Ethan has greatly enjoyed his time at Fulton. He would like to thank his friends, teammates, and coaches for making high school a fun and memorable experience. He wishes the best for all his fellow classmates and hopes we all each find our own success. Good luck, Ethan. Aisha Sheikh. Aisha would like to thank her family for their support throughout the years and her friends for all the laughs that they shared. Moving away will be tough, but she's grateful for all the memories that she gets to take with her. Aisha is receiving the following awards: the School District 22 Scholarship Trust Fund and the District Project Scholarship from the Ministry of Education. Well done, Aisha. Kai Shibata. Kai's 2 years at Fulton were wonderful. She learned many important things during her time here. She would like to thank her teachers, friends, and family for supporting her and say congratulations to all the other grads. Cheers, Fulton. Thank you to Kai for singing O Canada for us today. You sounded amazing. Good luck in the future, Kai. Jordan Sitko. In grade 7, Bitko never missed a day of school and had straight A's. Jordan would like to thank Mrs. Gaucher for still asking him when his games were and Ms. Tatro for helping him since grade 8. His future plans are to get a job in cosmetic repair at a car dealership in Vancouver. Best of luck, Jordan. Kelly Soares. Kelly would like to say thank you to her teachers, friends, and family for all the love and support throughout the years. She is excited to be graduating and plans to continue her education, working towards a business degree. Wishing you the best, Kelly. Tyson Soares. Tyson plans to continue his education and pursue a career as a med tech. He would like to thank his mom and dad for all their love and support and the family dinners. Best of luck, Tyson. Cadence Terran. Cadence's future plans after graduation are to go to nursing school to become a pediatric nurse. She would like to thank all her friends and teachers for a great high school experience and her mom and dad for helping her get through school. Cadence is the recipient of the HI Master's Bursary. Well done, Cadence. Congratulations. Samantha Taylor. Samantha's future plans are to attend a culinary arts program and to become a chef like her mom. Sam would like to thank Ms. Schroeder and Mrs. Harrison for being the best teachers. Good luck in the future, Samantha. Marcus Thistlewaite. Marcus would like to thank his family and friends for his time at Fulton. Congratulations, Marcus. We wish you the best of luck. Mark Fendu and Tian. When Mark first came from China, he didn't think he could last for a year, but he soon made friends and now he can't bear to leave. It all seems unreal. Mark will study business at Vancouver Island University. He wishes everyone the best in this difficult time. Best wishes for your future, Mark.
Okay.
Good job. Thank you. Nicholas Tilby. Nick would like to thank his mom and dad for bringing him to this world and raising him. Thank you to his aunts, uncles, and cousins for helping with the ride. A special thanks to his friends Isaac, Colin, Drew, Cole, Quita, Brandon, Sulman, Julia, Kelly, Shakira, Emma, Siji, and Ella. These are very special people to Nick, and he could always count on these friends to make him laugh, smile, and work harder so he could achieve his goals. Nick will always remember the games, class experiments, field trips, gym activities, Mission Impossible, grad activities, woodwork projects, art projects, cafeteria, and food class. Nick is thinking of moving to Vancouver to pursue his career as a sound engineer. He would also like to help children through music. He would like to be remembered as the fun-loving guy who helped others or who brought a smile to your face. Nick will be receiving the following award: the District Excellence Scholarship for ADST. Well done, Nicholas. Aiden Trottier. Aiden would like to thank his friends and family for all their help and support. He will cherish the memories that he made at Clarence Fulton Secondary and the people that helped make those memories. Aiden is excited to move on with life and go out and explore the world. He plans to get his brewmaster degree at Olds College. He thanks his mom and dad for helping him with the hardships of school. Aiden's motto is, "Never knock another man's hustle, because you never know another man's situation." Congrats, Aiden. Eric Urquhart. Thanks to the dual credit program, Eric was able to get his C-level welding at OC in grade 11. He plans to continue his flight training and become a commercial pilot. He would like to thank his parents, his grandpa, and Mr. Deschamps for helping him work towards his future goals. Eric is a deserving recipient of the District Project Scholarship from the Ministry of Education. Good luck with your future goals, Eric. Congratulations. Sa Vo. Sa would really like to thank all his teachers, his friends, and especially his family for all their love and support. His dad and mom are his heroes for supporting him and allowing him to come to Canada. Best wishes, Saw. Congratulations. Nam Vo. Nam Vo would like to thank all his teachers and especially Mr. Peter, who has helped all of us so much since the first day. He would also like to thank his second family for all of their support. Good luck, Nam. Congratulations. Min Vo. Min's future plan is to open up his own engineering firm and run his parents' gas station at the same time. He also plans on building houses and would like to thank his parents for all their help in guiding him towards his success. Min is receiving the following awards: the Clarence Fulton Staff Award, the Peter Eisman Memorial Math Scholarship, the Nixon Winger Scholarship, and the District Project Scholarship from the Ministry of Education. Way to go, Min. Quinn Williamson. Quinn will always remember those great memories he made with his friends at Clarence Fulton. He would like to thank his coaches, Dale Olson and Mike Scheller, for teaching him so much. Quinn would like to give a special thank you to his mom for getting him through school. Best of luck in the future, Quinn. Elizaveta Zinovieva. Elizaveta would like to say congratulations to all the grads of 2020. Elizaveta is the recipient of the District Project Scholarship from the Ministry of Education. Congratulations, Elizaveta. We would now like to honor Fulton's top graduating students with our special awards. The first of our special awards is for the top business education student. This student is an outstanding student. He achieved some of the highest marks in all the technology and business classes he was enrolled in. He also joined a very intensive program called Game of Apps, where students had to take courses on how to design and program. He was the chief programmer and team leader for the group. While doing this, he took a full course load at school and worked an after-school job. He is truly a dedicated and hard-working student. Congratulations to Sulman Ali, the top business education student. Our next award is for the top textiles and food sciences student. This student participated in all three areas of home economics. She has a clear passion for baking, cooking, and sewing. This student has shown her creativity with a variety of sewing projects. She has a clear passion for baking and cooking and is looking forward to continuing her family's tradition of culinary excellence while attending the culinary arts program at Okanagan College. This year's recipient of the Textiles and Food Sciences Award is Samantha Taylor. Congratulations, Sam. Our next award will be the top student in fine arts. In the fine arts, there will be one award for dramatic arts and one for the visual arts. The dramatic arts award goes to a student who entered dramatic arts in grade 8, and it was clear that this student was determined to be the best student actor ever. Over the course of her high school career, she took every single dramatic arts course that she could. In each course, she demonstrated the driving energy needed to bring art to life. Whether it was acting on stage, creating props, painting sets, doing special effects or makeup, designing posters, creating posters, or selling tickets, this student worked hard at every single element of the theater. In addition to her accomplishments at Fulton, which also includes photography for the yearbook, she has acted in Field of Screams and with the Powerhouse Theater. I am proud to announce the recipient of the Dramatic Arts Award, Jenna Faulkner. Congratulations, Jenna. In the visual arts, we have another award. For the past 5 years, this student has enrolled in every art course available to her, and she has always been the top in her class. Her natural ability in the art shines with her focus in pen and ink, combined with her watercolor style. Her work has been selected for local galleries at the Vertigo Gallery, as well as the Vernon Art Gallery. She was also awarded with the District Project Scholarship this year for her theme on goddesses and mystic empowered women and imagery. This year's top student for the visual arts is Kylie Murphy. Congratulations, Kylie. Our next award is Fulton's Female Athlete of the Year for 2020. Fulton Female Athlete of the Year is a three-sport athlete who played volleyball, basketball, and soccer. Her love for the game of soccer has been evident from an early age, as she also played rep soccer locally and then was a member of the TOFC soccer program. She is a person who always gave 100% effort in practices and games and also put in many hours of strength and conditioning training in school, out of school, and any time she had to pursue her athletic goals. She is a leader on the field and on the court. Her coaches describe her as being a dynamic athlete with a high sports IQ. exceptional athletic ability, and who is physically tough. Her future plans include studying kinesiology at the University of Winnipeg and playing soccer for the Westmen this fall. Fulton Female Athlete of the Year is Tori Hotman. Congratulations, Tori. Our next award is the Fulton Male Athlete of the Year. The recipient of the 2020 Grade 12 Male Athlete of the Year has excelled at three sports: volleyball, football, and basketball. During his time at Fulton, in his senior seasons, he played football and basketball. He was truly the leader of the basketball program. He is a dedicated, talented, and hardworking athlete. His vision on the court really made his teammates better. In addition to being a great athlete, this person is a model citizen and excels in academics as well. It is a pleasure to hand the Grade 12 Male Athlete of the Year award to Karan Malhotra. And now it's time for Fulton's Top Languages Student Award. This year's top language student already speaks two languages fluently at home and is well on her way to making it three. After spending a year learning French online so that she wouldn't fall behind, she recognized the need to get back into the classroom. And from the moment she arrived, she raised the bar for communication. However, what has impressed me most about this student is how she seeks out opportunities to apply her language skills outside of the classroom. Whether it's involving her brothers in an impromptu conversation, challenging herself to an advanced DELF test, or simply asking questions to improve her understanding, she is always striving to improve. This year's top language award goes to Aisha Sheikh. We will now present the Harold Rourke Award. The Harold Rourke Award is presented to the top academic student in our graduating class. Harold was a former Fulton principal and Vernon School District superintendent who was highly respected in our school and in our community. This year's recipient truly embraces learning. She consistently gets top marks in every single subject she takes. She is not only gifted in science and math, but gets just as high marks in languages, which is very rare. She also finds time to help her fellow peers with any questions they are having, and always does it with a big smile. She does not naturally reach for the spotlight, but will definitely shine if she is put there. Her 97% grade point average for her graduating year is truly remarkable. Rarely do you see an average so high. This young woman is truly all-round and exceptional. Her future is bright and will hold no limits. This year's Harold Rourke Top Academic Award goes to Aisha Sheikh. Congratulations. Our next award is for our top international student. This year we have two recipients. The first student came to Fulton at the start of her grade 10 year with very little English and even less confidence in her ability to use it. She was terrified but determined to do her best. She quickly gained the respect of both her classmates and her teachers as they began to recognize the strength that lies just beneath her quiet smile. She never took the easy road. She always fought to understand the stories and poems in her English classes directly instead of relying on translations. She always strove to write out her ideas in her own words instead of copying from other sources. As a result, her English improved quickly. She worked just as hard in her other classes and is now performing at a very high level. Sawako achieved a lot during her 3 years at Fulton, and we are all looking forward to witness what she will accomplish in her lifetime. Congratulations to Sawako Nakazoto, a top international graduate. Our other top international student award goes to a student who came back to Canada for her grade 11 and 12 years after a positive experience in grade 5 at Okanagan Landing Elementary. She returned to Vernon determined to make the most of her time at Fulton. She quickly became a key member of the acoustic jam community and was always willing to perform at different events, including the school barbecue and at the grad fashion show. She recognized the tendency in her own personality to withdraw from social situations and made a conscious decision to be more outgoing. She soon built a close group of friends and was always ready to welcome new international students from different cultures into her circle. We know that she will continue to improve herself and the lives of those around her wherever she ends up in the next stage of her life journey. Congratulations to Kai Shibata, another top international graduate. The Larry Grist Principals Award is presented annually to a student who is recognized by the staff for overcoming adversity with dignity and determination. This student is a determined young lady who has overcome obstacles in her life to participate in as many activities as she could. She took on these activities with resolve, effort, and performed her chosen activities well. Best of all, she had a smile on her face while doing it. In addition, this student is a capable, independent learner who has a strong work ethic. She is fully aware of her responsibilities and carries out her plans accordingly. When necessary, she is able to actively seek out solutions to setbacks and does so in a considerable manner. She is a perceptive and intelligent student who quietly supports her community and school on a daily basis. The recipient of the Larry Grist Principal Award is Jaslyn Bernakovich. Congratulations, Jaslyn. Fiza Akhtar. Fiza is being presented with a citizenship plaque for the significant contributions she has made to the school and the community. Congratulations, Fiza. Jenna Faulkner. Jenna is being presented with a citizenship plaque for the significant contributions she has made to the school and the community. Congratulations, Jenna. Julia Moore. Julia Moore is being presented with a citizenship plaque for the significant contributions she has made to the school and to the community. Congratulations, Julia. Kelly Soares. Kelly is being presented with a citizenship plaque for the significant contribution she has made to the school and to the community. Congratulations, Kelly. Nicholas Tilby. Nicholas Tilby is being presented with a citizenship plaque for the significant contribution he has made to our school and to our community. Congratulations, Nicholas. Min Vo. Min Vo is being presented with a citizenship plaque for his significant contributions to Fulton and the wider community. Congratulations, Min. We will now present our Al Kun Top Citizenship Award. Students are taught the importance of being good citizens by their families and by their educators. Civic responsibility is important to society. By exhibiting good citizenship skills, individuals show that they are productive and caring members of society. Good citizens treat each other with respect, they respect authority, and they are interested in helping society improve. The graduating class of 2020 has many outstanding citizens who have worked hard to make our school a positive environment to grow and learn. In many ways, this is always a difficult task to determine one top citizen, because every graduating class has many students who are deserving of this recognition. To select a top citizen means that this student has demonstrated through their kindness and their acts of service that they are willing to go the extra mile. It is difficult to narrow the choices, but we've managed to select an individual to be awarded this year's Al Kun Top Citizenship and Service Award. This student works hard in her academic endeavors. She respects authority. She works cooperatively with her peers and her educational mentors. She was the go-to gal for the class of 2020 when it came to planning and organizing grad activities. She was the go-to gal for helping to execute many of the fun leadership school activities and the leadership community events. And she was instrumental on the ladies' senior volleyball team. Her years of dedication and commitment to the program paid off in her senior years at Fulton. This young lady is liked by all. She practices inclusivity and knows how to get along with everyone. Her smile draws you in, and her positive nature makes you feel welcome and appreciated. Top citizens lead by example. This young lady is a natural leader, and her peers look to her for advice and for support. She is reliable, organized, prompt, dedicated, committed, and generous with her time. By now, you may have guessed who this year's recipient is. She was the only student nominated to be this year's Speaker of the Class. The student selected for this honor has learned that the more you give, the more you receive. This year's recipient of the Al Kuhn Top Citizenship and Service Award goes to Miss Kylene Richardson. Congratulations, Kylene. Our next award will be the Top Student in Technical Education. This student's strong technical ability, exemplary work ethic, and ability to problem solve allowed him to excel in technology classes. Some students have the practical hands-on skills and others have the technical knowledge. It is rare to find a student who excels in both. This student excelled in both. He was able to design his own final project, build prototypes, and complete a unique modern coffee table to exacting standards. He won a district scholarship award for his work on this coffee table. He was always willing to help his fellow classmates and mentored the grade 8 students as a peer tutor. It was a pleasure working with him, and we wish him the best in his future studies at UBC Okanagan next year. Min Vo is the top technology education student for 2020. Congratulations, Min. And finally, we will present this year's award for the graduating class of 2020's Top All-Around Student. The Top All-Around Award this year goes to a Fulton grad that does not just excel in academics, where he has close to a 96% GPA in his grade 12 year, but also found time in his busy schedule for extracurricular activities. This grad also played school sports, playing volleyball and rugby. He is also gifted in the woodwork class. His teacher would put him in the top 5 students he has ever taught. He also helps out a lot with leadership, always willing to contribute whenever asked. He also somehow found time to work many hours a week at his family business. In class, he spent countless hours helping his fellow students whenever they were stuck. This student leads by example. He has an exceptional work ethic, a positive attitude, and is a true model for his fellow grads. His future will hold no limits. This year's Fulton Top All-Around Award goes to Min Vo. Congratulations, Min. At this time, I would like to call Kylene Richardson, the Speaker of the Class, to come up and perform her speech.
Hello, my name is Kylene Richardson, and I am very honored to be the Speaker of the Class of 2020. Oh, 2020. I remember people saying to us throughout our lives that getting to graduate in the year 2020 must be so cool. But it's not the year that made it cool. It was the people that are here today that made the year 2020 so intriguing. Over my 5 years at Fulton, I've gotten to spend large amounts of time with these graduates, and I can tell you that they're all kind-hearted and inclusive people. Graduation is an honorable accomplishment that we looked forward to for years. We look forward to prom night and cap and gown photos with our friends. Grad has been the talking subject of the Grad Lounge since September, but we never expected this. Now, even though this definitely turned out to be an interesting time to be a high school senior, we all get to walk this stage and commemorate our time in high school together. Even though right around this time of year, we'd usually be racing to get alterations done, dreading final exams, and getting free food on Burger Day, instead, we're at home having video chats with teachers, writing essays in bed, and wishing we were at school to live our last glory days of high school. The graduating class of 2020 experienced a kind of hurt that not a lot of people have felt before. Those moments we looked forward to for years suddenly weren't happening anymore, and we had to adjust to the situation. It affected everyone a little bit differently, but we're all here together, virtually, with smiles on our faces and diplomas in our hands. Before I get too into this, my fellow graduates and I would like to thank all of the staff that helped us reach this milestone. Whether that be Thompson or Schrader trying to teach us stuff that only Andrew Cussfeller understands, or it's Scheller, Olson, or Shagas pushing us to stop being so lazy because our cardiovascular health is super important. All of the teachers and staff who helped us along the way, we thank you. An extra special thank you to the staff on the grad committee for not giving up on us and for making us the best grad it could be based on the circumstances. To my fellow graduates, I know saying goodbye to high school can be bittersweet. It's the last step in your life before you get pushed out into the real world to start adulting. It's the last bit of your childhood you have left, and you'll miss it. You'll miss the noises at Spirit Week. You'll miss the assemblies that got you out of class. You'll miss seeing your friends every day. But most importantly, as we've learned, you'll miss coming to school. Our legacy at Fulton will live on for years. Everyone will remember us as the virtual graduates, and I'm sure they won't remember anything else about us, so here's some things the class of 2020 did first. We were the first class to not have to take the English 12 provincial. We're the first class to not take provincials at all. We're the first class in years to not participate in the grads versus teacher softball game. And finally, we're the first class to experience a global pandemic during the best days of our lives. We may not have gotten to play in our last season of rugby or soccer, and we may not have gotten to participate in our last Hawaiian day, perform in the school play, or do our fetal pig dissections. What we did get to do is gain lifelong memories with the people we grew up seeing every day for 5 years. Our grad year may have gotten cut short, but we need to be thankful for what we did get to experience this year, such as the grad fashion show, Mission Impossible, grad retreat, and finally, our last Spirit Week. Our year was filled with awesome memories, and I thought I'd share a couple of my highlights. When Min and Nemo were the first people in 20 years to tip one of the canoes at Gardam Lake. When Hayden Catt shaved his head in front of the school dressed as Santa Claus at our Christmas assembly. When our last high school dance got cut short because of a really bad choice. And finally, when the yellow team finally won the Spirit Week games. We remember all of those memories because we participated in activities. So to all the younger people who may be listening, please never take going to school for granted. Be excited to go and see your friends every day. And all of those football games or pep rallies that you thought, maybe next year, go, because you never know when it's gonna be your last opportunity to do so, and sometimes it comes sooner than you think. And now, we all go our separate ways, whether we're going to post-secondary, working, or we aren't really sure yet. We're the future. We're the future lawyers, doctors, scientists, engineers, grocery clerks, and of course, a couple friendly McDonald's employees. Our future looks bright. We've got our whole lives ahead of us, and as we move on from this part of our lives, I hope we are able to look back and feel no regret. I hope we never forget the feeling of being a senior. I hope we never forget the stressful feeling that exams provided us. But most importantly, I hope we never forget to get the most out of our lives. To my fellow grads of 2020, I hope you're able to look back on this year with a smile. And someday when your kids start learning about the coronavirus at school, you can tell them all about the fun times you had in high school. We can tell them how it felt to score a touchdown and feel the whole school behind you. We can tell them about that time we aced our first test. We can tell them about all of our friends that got us through the tough times. And we can teach them to not live in the future or the past, but to live in the present. We may not have gotten to say a proper goodbye to each other, but we know it's not really a goodbye. And we may not have been lucky enough to sit here all together and throw our caps in the air, but I hope you still throw it, because graduation is something worth celebrating. We're the first class of the 2020s, and I'm proud to be a 2020 graduate, and I hope you are too. I wish good luck to you all, and thank you for making this year awesome for everyone. Here's to Clarence Fulton Secondary's first ever virtual graduates. Thank you.
Grads, remember, 2020 is not canceled. Each month adds a new twist, but with each twist, it has taught us something. We must continue to grow and to learn. This is the year that we need to band together instead of pushing others apart. Grads of 2020, your voices will be the change we want and the actions we need. Remember, 2020 is the most important year of all. It is the year you graduated and the year you left the relative safety of school to create the world we all need. This brings to conclusion our grad ceremony. Please join me in congratulating the Clarence Fulton graduates of 2020.
Hope when you take that jump, you don't feel the fall. Hope when the water rises, you built a wall. Hope when the crowd screams out, you're screaming your name. Hope if everybody runs, you choose to stay. Hope that you fall in love and it hurts so bad.
I was thinking about the band. I was thinking about the fans. We were underground, load of merch in that 12-passenger van in a small club in Minnesota, and the snow outside of First Ave. I just wanted my name in the star. Now look at where we at, still growing up, still growing up. I would lay in my bed and dream about what I've become. Couldn't wait to get older, couldn't wait to be some. Now that I'm here, wishing I was still young.
Told me, babe, that someday these would be the good old days. All the love you won't forget, and all these reckless nights you won't regret. Cause someday soon your whole life's gonna change. You'll miss the magic of the good old days.
Wish I didn't think I had the answers. Wish I didn't drink all of that blast first. Wish I made it to homecoming. Got up the courage to ask her. Wish I would've gotten out of my show. Wish I put the bottle back on that shelf. Wish I wouldn't have worried about what other people thought and felt comfortable with myself. Rooftop open and the stars above. Moment frozen, sneaking out and falling in love. Me, you, and that futon. We just begun. On the grass dreaming, figuring out who I was. Those good old days.
I wish somebody would've told me, babe.
We're still young. Maybe you always look back and think it was better than it was. Maybe these are the moments. Maybe I've been missing what it's about. Been scared of the future, thinking about the past while missing out on now. We've come so far. I guess I'm proud. And I ain't worried about the wrinkles around my smile. I got some scars. I've been around. I felt some pain. I seen some things, but I'm here now. Those good old days.
You don't know, whoa, whoa, what you got, whoa, whoa, till it goes, whoa, whoa, till it's gone. These good.